Everyone knows that hackers are the baddies of the internet, sinister outsiders who delight in spreading viruses, stealing data, and causing digital havoc. But is that really accurate? Sure, some do have a lot to answer for, but look a little closer and it becomes clear that instead of simply being the villains of the online world, hackers are actually the reason it exists. And what's more, they might even be able to offer us a useful way of thinking about the world and a model of how to change it for the better, the hacker ethic. To understand this unlikely sounding idea, it helps to know about hacking's origins, which lie not in computer code, but practical jokes. In the early 20th century, students at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology were famous for pulling pranks, or in MIT lingo, hacks, combining engineering smarts with mischievous experimentation. For instance, disassembling a car and reassembling it on a rooftop. That combination paid dividends when, in the 1950s, an exciting new technology arrived on campus – computers. Over the following decades, experimental hacking to see what these toys could do led to developments like ARPANET, a forerunner of the modern internet. Around the same time as this tech revolution, though, another revolution was happening, powered by peace, love, and psychedelics. Surprisingly, the nerds and hippies had a lot in common, with many pioneers exploring both technology and the counterculture. The result of this overlap was something that's now known as the hacker ethic. But while that might sound like a set of commandments carved in stone, this ethic is really more like a mindset, which can be roughly broken down into four core values. Curiosity, a compulsion to understand how things work, often by taking them apart. Creativity, a delight in finding clever and unexpected solutions to problems. Community, the belief that knowledge should be freely shared so that others can build on it. And nonconformity, a somewhat flexible relationship with rules, especially ones that clash with those other core values. Now, it's that last idea which helped earn hackers their dastardly reputation. But while there are cybercriminals using their skills for evil, there's also a rich history of hackers breaking rules for good reasons. Consider the Chaos Computer Club. In the 1980s, this Berlin-based hacker group repeatedly warned Germany's National Telecoms Agency that its security wasn't up to scratch. Eventually, fed up with being ignored, they proved their point by hacking in and stealing about $50,000. Classic cyber smash and grab, right? Except that, the very next day, they put it all back. Why? Because getting rich was never the point. This was a digital heist in the public interest. That doesn't make what they did legal, but does, arguably, make it ethical. Less Bonnie and Clyde, more Robin Hood with a dial-up modem. Yet focusing on high-profile hacks and their moral complexities can overshadow the fact that most hacking is less about breaking things than building them. Take self-described hacker Linus Torvalds. As a computer science student in the 90s, Torvalds was frustrated with Microsoft's tech monopoly, and so decided to fight back. Not by hacking their software, but creating something better. Linux, a free operating system that now underpins billions of Android phones and other devices around the world, and has become a figurehead of the open source movement. This transparent, collaborative approach to software is a great example of the hacker ethic in action, and has not only given us platforms like Wikipedia, but also countless other technologies without which the modern internet simply wouldn't function. But even that isn't the whole story, because the hacker ethic's true potential isn't limited to computing. Once you start looking, you can see it all over the place. In the right to repair movement, which helps people fix their own devices for cheap rather than paying exorbitant fees to controlling corporations. Or guerrilla gardeners who stealthily repurpose disused land they don't own to grow food for their neighbors. Or even punk music, which is really all about low-budget DIY creativity, grassroots shows and releases, and the spirit of rebellion. None of these would call themselves hackers, but they share the same curiosity about how things work, love of creative problem solving, community spirit, and skeptical attitude towards rules and regulations. Ultimately, those values are the beating heart of hacking, and the main reason that computing has gone from a nerdy hobby to an essential part of our lives, something I think is important to understand. Because while electronic outlaws obviously are a real thing, and we do need to protect ourselves online, demonizing hacking as a whole based on one bad aspect means we risk neglecting its upsides. That extends beyond how much the hacker ethic has shaped the modern world to all we stand to gain by adopting it for ourselves. Being active creators rather than just passive consumers, forming communities with like-minded people, and thinking independently about our ethical choices. With those values to guide us, we can all be hackers. No coding skills required.